This is Francesco with the Scoop News. Okay, we're talking about CRA, the redevelopment agency that the city and county, city of Sarasota and the county have been fighting over about $5 million when you look at interest and everything and repayment for this redevelopment agency. I listened to the county meeting last week and they were, I think it was last week or 2 weeks ago, and they were a little upset that the city of Sarasota, A, did not discuss it at their last meeting, and B, that they were basically saying, look, we're tired of the city. We don't like the fact that they're threatening litigation, and we made an offer, and we really don't want to do anything. This is it. They were taking a pretty hard line, basically everybody on that panel. So this go around, the city leaders in Sarasota on Monday got together and said, okay, look, let's look at the different projects. Let's try to do a do-over so that we can settle this without going through litigation. So they came up with a couple offers that they'd like to present to the county. And I'm sure the county's going to counter-offer back, which they normally do. Hopefully they can come together and end this fight that's been going on for a while. Like I said, it's about $5 million, and it's been hotly debated, even within the city of Sarasota, within their own chamber there, they've been debating the issues. But what they're coming back with their consensus is to restore the $320,000 per year that's been used to fund the Robert L. Taylor Community Complex, to extend the $432,000 leftover funding that's been provided to help clean up the dump at Marian Anderson Place over there on Martin Luther King. It's being reported that's part of the consensus. It's also being reported that they want the county to help fund the creation of a JALT training and apprenticeship center over there at Marian Anderson Place site once the city picks up the development plans. I don't know. I'm pretty sure the county's going to come back with a county counter offer on this. And, and the city will come back and we'll see where we end up. Hopefully they can come together with this instead of continuing to argue this down the road. This all extends from just the changing of a timeline for their annual resetting of the base year. And the city, basically the county came in and said, look, first the city leaders came in, they said, they reset the base year. And the county said, you can't do that without our approval. And it impacts the funding. This is how the funding's impacted, which is the $5 million issue. City leaders are arguing, hey, we can reset the base year on our own. We don't need to go through you. And the county's contributions would be minimal at about $12,000 in the first year and up to $61,000 by the fifth year. So that's estimates of the city. Where we stand, who knows? How many people will actually listen to this video? Doubt it that many, because most people aren't involved at the county or city level. So we'll see where it goes. This has been Frankie Abbruzzino with the Scoop News.